Other day, I was talking about filters. Everyone remembered that? That I was talking about Sirlet filters, guys. A filter is a special web component of the web application who traps the request, traps the response. By trapping request, it will apply pre-request processing logics. By trapping response, it will apply post-response generation logics. I hope everyone remembered that. On 14th November, we discussed all these things, right? Three types of filters are the request filter, the trap request and response, but they contain only pre-request processing logic. Response filter, the trap request and response, but they contain only post-response generation logics. Request response filter, they contain both request and response logics. Okay, guys. Every filter will have filter config object, which is a right hand object to filter class object, guys. Come on. Using that filter config object, we can know about filter. We can get information about filter. Yeah, what is Sirlet filter API? We have a filter interface. Generic filter class is implementing that interface. STP filter class is extending from generic filter class. Everyone getting my point, guys? Okay. So this HTTP filter class is having two filter methods. One is do filter, sirlet request, sirlet response. Other one is do filter, HTTP sirlet request and HTTP sirlet response. Having filter chain object as the parameter. Having filter chain object as the parameter. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay, guys. Yeah. On one sirlet component, we can apply multiple filters. Filter one traps the request, passes to filter two. Filter two traps the request, passes to filter three. And filter three passes to sirlet component. And reverse will happen. Things will happen in reverse order. Okay, guys. Listen, filter change object holds next filter information in the chain or destination web component information. Okay, the filter chain object of filter one holds filter two details. Filter chain object of filter two holds filter three details. Filter chain object of filter three holds destination sirlet component, destination sirlet component information. The destination sirlet component information. Okay, guys. If multiple filters are trapping requests in the chain, in which order they are trapping the requests, exactly in the reverse order they trap the response. Okay, sample filter code, guys. Init method contains initialization logic. Destroy method contain initialization logic. In the middle, we have a do filter method is there. Before chain dot filter, it will be having pre-request processing logic. After chain dot do filter, it will be having what? Post-response generation logic. Okay, to map, a filter can be mapped with one or more sirlet component. Multiple filters can be mapped with one or more sirlet components. To map filter with one sirlet component, you should pass servlet URL pattern of filter URL pattern. To map two filters with one servlet component, you should pass servlet URL pattern with those two filters URL pattern. To map one filter with the two servlet component, so you should have a common directory for both the filter servlets, guys. Then test one slash r, test one abc, test one xyz, test one slash star. Okay, to map two filters with the two different servlet component, okay, test one abc, test one xyz, servlet one, servlet two, test two abc, test two xyz, servlet three, servlet four. Filter one is mapped with what? Test one slash star. Filter one maps with what? Test one slash star. Maps with servlet one and comma servlet two, guys. Filter two URL pattern is slash test two slash star. Maps with servlet three and servlet four, guys. And I'm just revising everything, boss. If you want to map filter with all request and all responses with all web component, then we have to use slash star. Slash star. Okay. By default, servlet container creates filter class object during server startup or during deployment of web application and will be destroyed when you stop or reload or undeploy the web application. Right, boss. There is no filter context object, but we can get access to servlet context object by using filter config object. Right, boss. So let us develop some filters today, guys. Some interesting filters today. So what is this? Servlet filters 19th. Yeah, today is 20th. November 20th. Nice. Okay, now listen, first one, developing servlet filter that allows request to all the web components of web application between nine AM to five PM. Between nine AM to five PM. Between nine AM to five PM. Yeah. Any application you take, guys. Step number one. Keep any web application ready. Keep any web application ready. Okay, I'll keep one of the existing web application is ready, guys. Hey everyone, I think I have informed properly to you people about today's class. Okay, there is a web application called Corona APP application. What is that? Any application I can take. I think Links APP is there. Links APP application is there, guys. Links APP application. Okay, Links APP application. Okay, here servlet filters is the name I am taking. Servlet filters. Yes, guys. Right click properties. Properties, web project settings. Array, I have announced yesterday also. Today we have a class at 4 PM as a common topic. Right. Fine. Okay, boss. Done, boss. Yeah, my admin will inform na if they join in 4 PM link. Right, boss. Tell me, guys. com.nt.filter. com.nt.filter. Yes. Tell me here. Nice. Time check filter, guys. What, guys? Time check filter. Time check filter. How does it becomes filter, guys? Either by using, by implementing filter interface, or by extending from generic filter class, or by extending from HTTP filter, by extending from HTTP filter class, right? Okay, here we are having HTTP filter. Save finish. Hereby having HTTP filter class. Yeah, public class time check filter extends HTTP filter, guys. Okay, how does it become filter, guys? Okay, we have a annotation. 11 o'clock students, don't worry. We can configure either in web.xml or by using what? At the rate web filter annotation. No problem. Anything is okay. It's an easy way. It is called annotation. I'll introduce annotations later for you. Slash star. Slash star means what? It will trap every request, every response coming to this web application or not. Easy. It's a URL pattern. If you don't want to use filter mapping, there you have to write URL pattern as slash star. So choice is yours. Now listen. Okay, init method, destroy method not required right now. Right now I'm just looking for what? Do filter method. Okay, what method, guys? Do filter method. Done. Okay, here is what? Public void do filter. HTTP servlet request req, HTTP servlet response res, filter chain, throws servlet exception, comma, IO exception. Throws what? IO exception, comma, servlet exception, guys. Now listen, get the current date and time. Get system date and time. System date and time. Okay. Array annotations are special statement. They will mark Java code. They will configure Java code alternate to XML game JK gaming. Okay. Alternate to XML configuration. Annotations are alternate for XML configurations. Tell me, guys, into hour is equal to. Okay, here I will take local date time. Local date time LDT. Okay, local date time dot now. Local date time dot now. Super, guys. Tell me, get current hour of the day. Get what? Current hour of the day. Are you understanding my statement? Okay. How to get current hour of the day? Int hour is equal to LDT dot get. LDT dot get. Come on. Why LDT dot get? LDT dot hour. LDT dot get hours. Tell me, if hour is greater than 9, greater than or equal to 9, and hour is greater than or equal to 9, and hour is less than or equal to 17. 17 means 5 o'clock, and less than or equal to 17, 5 o'clock. Then what is this? Chain dot do filter. Request comma response. Chain dot do filter. Request comma response. Everyone understood my point, guys? Okay. Are end only na? If it is in between both the timings, everyone, between, in between both the timings. Hello. Okay, execute next filter or destination. Next filter or destination web component. Super, guys. Next filter or destination web component. Else, I would like to generate the error message from the filter itself. Okay, how to generate error message from the filter itself? For that purpose, let me get the print writer. Get print writer. Print writer PW is equal to res dot get writer. Set response content type. Res dot set content type. HTML. Okay, guys. Array, it is R symbol, end symbol. Array, it should be end symbol only, na? Okay, guys. One minute. Greater than or equal to 9. Okay, fine. Else. Greater than or equal to 9. Understanding my statement? Okay, now tell me here. PW.println H1 style color colon red text hyphen align center. Okay, text hyphen align center. Okay, request must be given. Between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Request must be given between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Here is return semicolon. What is that? Return semicolon. A-L-I-G-N. Align is equal to center. Request must be given between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Okay, boss. After that, what next? Close it. Close the stream. PW.close. Close the stream. PW.close. Yeah, it will trap all the requests. If request is before that, yes, it won't allow. Now listen, it is a request. It is what request, guys? Pre-request. It is having only pre-request processing logic. before calling chain dot do filter only some logic is executing, right boss? After chain dot do filter no logic is executing, so that's why it is comes under request filter only. Okay, no problem. Yeah, let's run this application, boss. Run as right now. What is that? 4:32. Right now, what is the timing? 4:32. Remove all. Say finish. 1 minute. Did I change the context path of the project? Because when I copy paste, better to change the context path. Yeah, it's already changed, boss. Run on server. Come on. Yes. Yeah, see, it is 4:33. That's why it is happily allowing all the requests to take place. All countries done. System date and time done. Okay, right click, adjust date and time. Right click, adjust date and time. Okay, now I'm changing time manually to 4:30 a.m. Early morning 4:30 a.m. Okay, say refresh. Request must be given 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Are you noticing it, guys? It is trapping all the requests and is not checking the time. So, checking the time. Notice the time is what? Oh, wow. Actually, it's coming from buffer, guys. Even first request also. Even first request also should not come. Request must be given 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. It's coming or not coming? Okay. Now I'm changing the time, guys. If I keep it dynamically, date and time will be changed. Refresh. All languages, everything is happening. Easy. So slash star trapping all the request and response or not? All the request. Actually, I have given first for initial request going to welcome file. That means HTML file. That also will be trapped. That also will be trapped. Okay. Control comes here. Gets the current hour of the day. Let us assume early morning 4:30 a.m. 4:30 a.m. has come. That means 4 has come. 4 greater than or equal to 9. 4 greater than or equal to 9. No. Okay, no need of checking second condition. Control comes to else block, return statement. So that's a chain dot do filter is not executed. That means next filter in the chain or destination component is not going to execute. Next filter in the chain or destination component is not going to execute. Are you listening my statement, guys? Next filter in the chain or destination component is not going to execute. Is that clear, my dear? Okay. So let us assume I have given request at 10 o'clock. I have given request to in a welcome file input.html. What is the URL pattern of the filter? Slash star traps the request. Executes do filter method. Come on. Gets the time. Gets the current hour of the day, 10 o'clock. If hour greater than or equal to, 9, condition true. And 10 less than or equal to 17, condition true. Okay, chain dot do filter. So chain dot do filter, originally request is given to whom? HTML file. It will send the request to HTML file. HTML page will come. Okay, I clicked on hyperlink. When I click on hyperlink, where the request going, boss? When I click on hyperlink, request is going to another web component. What is that? Links URL. Again, filter traps the request. Again, checks the date and time. What is the current hour of the day? 10 o'clock. Is 10 greater than 9 and less than 17? No. Okay, condition is true. Satisfied. Chain dot to filter. Happily, servlet will execute. Happily, the servlet will execute. Easy, boss. Okay. Keep any web application ready. Super, guys. Step number 2. Add add filter component, add, right, it is not there to modify existing servlet component logic, guys. It is there, okay, to add additional functionalities to the web application without touching the existing web components of the web application. Add filter components, add filter component to web application having the URL pattern /*, having the URL pattern /*, as shown below, /*, as shown below. Copy, guys. Time check filter dot java, guys. Time check filter dot java, guys. Okay. Array, where this time check will happen, sir? Stock market trading application. Stock market trading application. They allow trading between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., right? That time this filter is very, very important or not? The website that allows, okay, stock market trading. The website that allows stock market trading. Okay, stock market trading. Okay, allows to perform trading activities between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Array, let us assume, guys, 5 p.m. only. So 3:30 only, na? Fine. Okay, you write condition accordingly. So at that time, it is useful or not? Okay. Sir, timer service is different, Bhagyasri madam. Timer service, that is a timer. Timer service is a component. It's nowhere related to filter. For that one, you should have jQuery, AngularJS components. Someone asked a timer service, how to create timer service. Okay, for that one, we should use advanced UI components offered by jQuery Angular. That's UI people will take care of that. UI people will take care of that. Run the application. Okay, run the application. Step number 3. Run the application. Okay, boss. Right, guys. Now tell me, developing servlet filter component. Developing servlet filter component that checks, that allows request from certain browser. That allows request from certain browser softwares only. Certain browser, nothing but Chrome browser only. Yeah, array, did you notice the launch of Chrome? Okay. Launch of Chrome. When they launch Chrome, if you try to open Google or Gmail, they used to threaten you. Okay, this website may not work properly other than Chrome browser. Please install Chrome. Like this, they used to threaten you. Remember that? In the initial days of Chrome launching, boss. Now that headache is not there. But in the initial days of Chrome browser, they used to threaten you like this. I hope you remember that kind of statements, boss. developing servlet form filter component that allows requests from certain browser software, nothing but Chrome only, nothing but Chrome. Yes, I want to develop such kind of thing. So shall I go for first step? Step number one, keep the web application ready. Keep the web application ready. Step number two, develop the servlet filter component. Yeah. Are this also should trap every request and check and should check whether browser type is Chrome or not. If the request is coming from other than Chrome, reject the request. Reject the request. Having okay URL pattern, having URL pattern slash star. Develop the servlet filter component having the URL pattern slash star. Why slash star, guys? To trap all requests, all responses of all web component. Okay, nice boss. So in the same filter, I am adding one more class. What is that? What is that? Chrome browser check filter. Browser check filter. What is the super class, guys? HTTP filter. Browser check filter. What is this? At the rate web filter. If you don't want to use annotation, you can configure it in web.xml. This I will try to configure from web.xml. Do filter method, guys. I will try to take it as a public method, boss. Public wide do filter request comma response. Public wide do filter request comma response. Right, boss. Tell me here. Or a get print writer. Get print writer object. Print writer pw is equal to res dot get writer. Okay, set content type res dot set content type HTML. Okay, get browser name. What is that, guys? Get browser name. String br name is equal to request dot get header of user hyphen agent. Request dot get header of user hyphen agent. Request dot get header of user hyphen agent, boss. Nice. Request dot get header of user hyphen agent. Super, boss. After that, what next? Request dot get header of user hyphen agent, boss. User hyphen agent. Now listen, if browser dot content contains browser dot contains Chrome. Somewhere Chrome should be there, guys. Somewhere Chrome should be there. Then what? Chain dot do filter. Same. Okay. Executes next filter or destination web component. Executes next filter or destination web component. Else Yes, as usually. What is this? PW dot println h1 style color colon. Tell me, guys. Color colon red. No, we cannot say only equals chrome because very lengthy string will come. If you want, I will print that one for you. Sysout browser. Very lengthy will come. Somewhere in the middle, chrome will be there. Okay. Yes, guys. Red. Text hyphen align center. Okay. Request must be given. Must be given from Chrome browser. Must be given from Chrome browser. Right. No further execution. Return semicolon. Does not allow to execute further lines. Does not allow to execute further line. Okay, boss. Whatever it is, I am trying to close the stream. Okay, if you don't close the stream also, not a issue, but I am trying my level best. End of do filter method. Okay, end of. End of do. Array, this is for display purpose. Right? For us to display, I have it placed. For to show that browser name comes very length, I have shown. Wanted, I have a sense of writing that. Browser check filter, guys. What is that? Browser check filter we are having. Here we are checking the browser, boss. Where is the URL pattern, guys? Here is the URL pattern. @ web filter slash star. Okay, I think we decided to configure using XML. Okay, let me give knowledge of configuring with XML also. Web.xml, guys. Okay, how we got servlet and servlet mapping? Yeah, you can configure few with XML, few with annotation, no problem. Filter, guys, under this, very lengthy. See, in annotation, one line it completed. If it is a filter, lot of hangama you should write. Why? Code somewhere in configuration somewhere means you should write multiple details about the code first. Okay. Browser is the logical name. Filter hyphen class, guys. com.nt.filter. What is this? Browser check filter. Filter mapping. Filter name, browser. Okay, URL pattern, slash star. Same, here also same. See, I have to write these many lines of code, guys. If it is annotation, just put on the top of it. That's over. You just put on the top of it. That's the end of the story, right? Okay. Fine, boss. Now listen. Right. Right now timing is 4:51. Time is correct time only. Time is in the range. So browser also Chrome browser. But default browser I have chosen is Chrome browser. That's why links are coming. Everything is coming, right? Output is also coming nicely. Okay. Same URL I have taken, copied, pasted in the Firefox browser. Copy pasted in the Firefox browser. Save paste, guys. Save paste. What's happening? Firefox, you see, earlier Chrome has come. No, sir. Earlier Chrome has come. This time Firefox is coming. Firefox is coming, but we are not able to see any error message. Why it is not showing any error message? Okay. I supposed to get one or other error message now, boss. 1 minute. Browser check filter, guys. Browser check filter. We are printing this. Browser contains Chroma. No. Else, what we are doing? We are printing this message, right? ALIGN. Oh, understood. Wrong, wrong. And the single quote also not closed, guys. The single quote also not closed. Understood? Incomplete tag, guys. Okay. No, that's not an issue. Run the application. Success part is happened nicely. Failure part is giving problem. Now come here. This is happening. Come here. Refresh. Request must be given from Chrome browser. Or if giving return statement is optional, guys. Giving return statement is optional. To tell that, don't execute further statement. Return statement without value does not execute further code. If you don't write also, no problem. Anyhow, we are writing in else block, not a problem. I think you understood this statement, guys. Come on. Easy. You understood without touching. Tomorrow, my website is even ready for working with Chrome browser. Sorry. Other than Chrome browser. Just comment the filter, guys. Just comment the filter or comment the filter annotation. Now you observe. Refresh. Give time for server IDE. User-agent is a predefined one. No doubt in that. User-agent is a predefined one. Okay. I think nowadays this IDE is not refreshing the things automatically. Rerun this application. User-agent is a predefined request header. How refresh is there? Similarly, we have this. Now, this time, no restriction, guys. This time, Firefox browser, no restriction. Everyone got the clarity, boss? Come on. Okay, boss. Okay. In which order they are configured, in the same order they will be happening. Okay. Right. Listen, only for that, I don't want to give web.xml code. Right, boss. @filter/star. Okay. Suppose you want to restrict on Firefox browser. What you write, guys? You want to restrict Firefox browser. In the place of Chrome, you write Firefox, dirty fellow. Abhi, why do you behave like this, boss? Why do you behave like a 10th class student? Abhi, why do you behave like a 10th class student? Please behave like an engineering student now, boss. Earlier, what is the message I got? Chrome I am getting. If you want restrict on Firefox, you should write what? Firefox here. If you want restrict Edge browser, Edge here. I hope you can behave at least as a graduate. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay. Right. Let me give the feeling. Okay. Let me give the feeling. Both filters are executing, guys. Sys trace do filter, browser check filter, here also sys trace. Okay, here also sys trace. Okay, now you observe, right click, run on server, save first, save finish. Okay, look at both. Time check do filter. I will tell why other one is not executing. at the rate web filter time check is there. Browser check, year not applied, year also commented. That's why that is not happening. Did you notice it? Okay, but here I will keep it. Here I will keep it. Now I'm keeping both. Now I'm keeping both, guys. Run on server. Say next. Say finish. Say next. Say finish. This is coming from buffer. Don't believe that. Tell me what's happening. Browser check filter, then time check filter. One is browser check filter. Other one is what? Time check filter. Okay. Sir, why browser check filter is coming first? See, if they are configured in XML, in which order they are configured, in the same order they will come. But if they are configured with annotation, server decides the order. Server decides the order based on alphabetics. Alphabetic order it will use, guys. Alphabetic order it uses. Understanding? Okay. Okay. Tell me, guys. If multiple filters are configured on servlet component, the order of, come on. Okay, the order of Krishna, only for servlet and filters configuration is required. If at all you are not going for annotation, for HTML file, XML file, JSP file, configuration in web.xml is optional. I kept on telling this statement. If multiple filters are configured on servlet component, using XML configurations, okay, then the order of trapping request, then in which order the request is trapped. Okay, in the same order, in the reverse order. Okay, in which order request is trapped. 1 minute. In which order the filter components are configured in web.xml file, the request will be trapped. And the response will be trapped. Will be trapped in the reverse order. In the reverse order. And the response will be trapped in the reverse order. Okay, guys. Right, guys. If the same multiple filters are configured using annotations, then come on, guys, then based on the alphabetic order of filter class names, the request trapping and response trapping order will be decided. The request trapping and response trapping order will be decided. Is that clear from my side, guys? Right, boss. So far, what filters we developed? They are request filters, guys. Okay. Why? They are having logic to execute before trapping the request. After trapping the response, no logic to execute. See? Is there any logic after chain dot do filter? No. Is there any logic after chain dot do filter in the previous example? No. Every logic is there to execute before chain dot do filter, right? So that's why can we call these all these are request filters, guys. All these are request filters. Okay, now I would like to develop such a filter which acts as both request and response filter, guys. Which acts as a both request and response filter. Yeah, best example for request and response filter is performance test filter, guys. Okay, guys. Listen, guys, every logic you try to take in a separate filter. Why? Whenever you want, we should on. Whenever you want, we should off. Suppose first restriction is there 9 to 5. After that, no restriction. We should remove the filter. If you write multiple logics in one filter, onning and on, switching on, switching off is very difficult, right? Understanding my statement? So that's why don't keep multiple logics in one filter, because sometimes you want to on them, sometimes you want to off them. Loose coupling purpose, try to keep only one logic in one filter. Don't try to keep 2-3 logics in one filter. Come on. Use servlet filters. Placing optional request processing or request processing and response processing. Acha, pre-request processing and post-response processing logics, which can be enabled or disabled on demand basis without affecting other logics in other web components of the web application. Everyone got the clarity, boss? Come on. Yes, guys. So right now, what is this filter, guys? Request filter. Because it is having only pre-request processing logic. What is this filter, guys? Request filter. Okay, guys. Now, develop filter component. Okay. That evaluates the performance of each web component by getting its request processing time. Okay, guys, by getting its this filter component must be developed as request-response filter. Okay, guys. Trap the request, get the time. trap the response, get the time. Find out difference between response trapping time and request trapping time. Okay, if the difference is less, performance is good. If the difference is more, performance is bad. Okay, shall I develop that one, boss? One more filter I am adding. Okay, guys, here is class. Performance test filter. Super class. Okay, I think this time, okay, fine, no problem. HTTP filter. Okay, HTTP filter. Right, guys. Do filter as usually. Okay, here long start time is equal to 0L. Tell me, end time is equal to 0L. Long start time is equal to 0L. End time is equal to 0L. Got it? Yes. Now first it is trapping the request, guys. Tell me. Start time is equal to system dot current time millisecond. System dot current time in milliseconds. Start time is equal to system dot current time in milliseconds. Cool, guys. Okay, next one. Chain dot do filter. Don't restrict anything, guys. Let the request goes to next one. Next filter or destination servlet component. End time is equal to current time in milliseconds. End time is equal to current time in milliseconds. Are you listening my statement, guys? Come on. Okay. Here I got the start time. Here I got the end time. Are you comfortable, my dears? Come on. Super. After that, what is the next story? Now, I would like to write a message on the console. System.out.println. System.out.request.getRequestURI. Request.getRequestURI has taken. Okay. Listen, now total three filters are there. They will be interlinked. First filter will have second filter information. Second filter will have third filter information. This filter chain object will have like this. Come on. Request.getRequestURI has taken. See, guys, this is request trapping time. Because of that, goes to next filter or destination component, whatever it is. Next, response trapping time. System.getRequestURI has taken end time minus. End time minus start time milliseconds has taken end time minus start time milliseconds to process the request. Okay, to process the request. Are you understanding my statement, guys? I am writing on the console. If you are interested, you can write to the log file. 4 p.m. students, I have shown how to write to the log file. sc.log method is there na. Using that, you can write to the log file also. It's up to you. What is this request.get request URL? I guess complete URL will get. Complete URL you will get. Tell me. I want to see, this is also trapping the request, guys. @webfilter/*. Because I want to evaluate performance of even HTML component also. I want to evaluate this one. Now I have to change the time, guys. If I don't change the time, sorry, I cannot make this request happening, boss. Okay. Let's make it 4:13 for some time. Let's make it 4:13 for temporarily. Run on server. Say next. Say finish. Okay. Browser is Chrome browser. Super. Okay. Let's see. Actually, it is coming from buffer. Don't believe this output. Refresh. Sometime it output comes from buffer. Links servlet. Initial request has taken 3 milliseconds, guys. 3 milliseconds to process the request. That means home page, whatever home page, welcome page is coming, that has taken 3 milliseconds to process the request. Cool, guys. Now listen, next one. All languages, it is giving request to servlet component. It has taken 122 milliseconds to process the request. 122 milliseconds. Again, launching HTML file. Okay. It is coming from buffer. Don't trust it. Refresh. Now listen. It has taken 4 milliseconds to process the request. Are able to evaluate the performance or not? Come on. Okay. They are taking less amount of time. That means they are good, doing good performance. So we are able to make it as a request response filter. How, sir? Okay, request processing logic, pre-request processing logic, post-response generation logic. Both logics are placed here or not? Both logics are placed here or not? I want reply, boss. Performance test filter dot Java. Copy this. Here is paste. That's it, boss. This is request response filter, boss. This is my request to response filter. Request to response filter. This is seriously what? Request to response filter. /*. It has taken end time minus start time milliseconds to process the request. Are you comfortable, guys? Come on. This is start time. This is end time. Okay. Everyone got the clarity? Filters are not there to disturb the existing process, guys. Filters are already always there. Filters are always there. Come on. To add additional and optional logic without disturbing existing logics of the application. Having ability to enable, having ability to disable as needed. So we have developed different types of filters or not. Okay. Array, every filter is also internally one kind of servlet. But they don't deal with main request processing logic. They always deal with pre-request processing and post-response generation logics. Pre-request processing and post-response generation logics. Okay. This is our web component setup, guys. I'm going to give directory structure. I think you are enjoying importance of the snipper tool, right? Okay. Here are the filters. These are the filters that we have developed. Okay. With this servlet filters concept is completed, boss. Tomorrow at 11 o'clock. I'm passing to everyone. Tomorrow at 11 o'clock, we have a session on Sarlet wrappers. Tomorrow at 11 o'clock, we have a session on Sarlet wrappers. Thank you. Have a nice time. Using same link. Link is special classes link. Link is special classes link, right? Thank you. Have a nice time.